Welcome students to chapter number 3, political parties. We are going to look at the third part of this chapter. This chapter is presented by Gracia and Mosquito. The images and information used in this video are taken from different internet sites. Our learning objectives for this video are regional parties, the changing nature of regional parties in India in the present times. We are going to look at different regional parties, that is Shiv Sena, Shiromani Akali Dal, Jammu and Kashmir National Conference, Assam Jan Parishad, Dravida Munetra Kazagam, and regional parties present in Maharashtra. The development of regional feelings in India goes back to British rule. The various acts of the British government had planted and sustained the regional feelings. However, the creation of the first linguistic state of Andhra in 1953 was a major cause of the beginning of regional movements in India, thus giving rise to the concept of having a regional party. The influence of regional parties is limited to a particular region. As you all know, regional parties are those groups in the region who have proud feeling about the different identity of their region and who compete to get political power with the objective of regional development. Regional parties also first give preference to their own regional problems. As you all know that the regional parties came into existence in India during the post-independence period. Thus, the role and the significance of these parties have been changing over the years till today. In India, regional parties have been coming up at regular intervals, playing different roles in the country's parliamentary democracy. Some parties like the Shiromani Akali Dal and the Jammu and Kashmir National Conference were even founded before the country gained independence in 1947. But most of the other parties came into existence after country attained freedom. One of the oldest regional parties is the Shiromani Akali Dal, which was established in the year 1920. At present, regional parties are ruling either on their own or in alliance with a national party or with other parties. The changing nature of these parties are: initially, regional parties gave rise to separatist movement. Separatist movement is basically the one that demands a separate state on the base of culture, ethnicity, or race. The Dravidian were made with the objective of parting from the Indian Federation. The demand for independent Khalistan was also given. Regional parties from Punjab, Tamil Nadu, and Jammu and Kashmir have made such demands. The demands of regional parties gradually changed. Instead of an independent state, they started demanding more autonomy. Autonomy basically means more freedom in ruling and governing the state or the region. regional parties have challenged the national parties because of their major support from that region. They also started exploiting the national party's objectives by neglecting the political and economic interest of the region or even the state. This was the second stage in the development of the regional parties. At present, some of them are ruling in their respective states and others are waiting for their turn to come to power. This stage began after the year 1990. The regional parties demanded that for the development of the region, people from the region should get power at the state and national level. A major trait of all these parties is that they are controlled and driven by one leader who runs large in party affairs and whose commands cannot be challenged. Even parties which justify their respective existence on some ideological grounds have been converted into individual or self-interest preserving outfits with the passage of time. For example, the parties that are demanding power at the national level are Shiv Sena, Telugu Desam Party. The development of regional parties in Northeast shows a different trend. They gave up their demand of separatism and have started demanding more autonomy. The regional parties from the Northeast are now entering into the national politics. The growth of state parties which fall under regional parties picked up after 1967 when the hold of Indian National Congress began to weaken after the freedom struggle. There are about 4 dozen recognized state parties and about 2 dozen more which are not yet recognized by the Election Commission of India. In short, we can say that the role of regional parties in India has passed through various phases, from separatism to autonomy, and now towards entering into mainstream national politics. Coalition politics is one of the consequences of their increasing influence in national parties. At present, regional parties are ruling either on their own or in alliance with a national party or with other parties in different states of India like Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir, Nagaland, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, etc. In India, we have many regional parties and it is not possible to know about all. Bal Thackeray, in full Bala Saheb Keshav Thackeray, was born on January 23, 1926 in Pune, Maharashtra. He was an Indian journalist and a politician. He also is the founder of the Shiv Sena political party in Maharashtra, which is also known as the Army of Shiva. And he advocated a strong pro-Hindu policy in India. Under his regime or leadership, the Shiv Sena became a dominant political force in the western Indian state of Maharashtra. In the 1960s, he became increasingly involved in Indian politics. He developed a strong regional feeling and following through his work for a weekly Marathi language journal called the Marmik, which he published with his brother and which he polemicized against after the influence of the outsiders in Maharashtra. And he founded this party in the year 1966 and called it the Shiv Sena Party. Shiv Sena is a regional political party of India which was formed by the late cartoonist Bahar Thackeray in the year 1966. The party was formed to build a movement to help Marathi job aspirants to procure job opportunities in Mumbai. In 1968, Shiv Sena entered the political framework of Bombay by winning 42 seats out of 121 in civic elections, which gradually extended its base on a pan-India level, and it aligned with the Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP, in Maharashtra. Shiv Sena and BJP's alliance came into power for the first time in the year 1995, and Manohar Joshi, prominent Shiv Sena leader, became the chief minister of the state. The main objectives of the Shiv Sena party is the protection of the rights of Marathi people, promotion of the Marathi language, and resistance to people from other regions. After elections in 2019, it formed the government in alliance with the Congress Party and the National Congress Party. Shiromani Akali Dal, also called as Akali Dal, is a regional party in the Punjab state of northwestern part of India. It is an organization that comprises of the large Sikh community in the state and is centered on the philosophy of promoting the well-being of the country's Sikh population by providing them with a political as well as a religious platform. This party also has a presence on the national political scene in New Delhi. The party also won majority of seats in the 1977 state assembly elections and formed a government with Prakash Singh Badal as chief minister. It was Badal's second term in the office, as he had served in the year 1970 and 71 during the first Shiromani Akali Dal led government. The present day Shiromani Akali Dal was an organization established in December 1920 to help the Akali movement of the early 1920s, in which Sikhs demanded and won from the ruling British authorities in India control over the Gurudwaras. The present day Shiromani Akali Dal, which has claimed to be the oldest regional political party in India, has also controlled Sikh religious institutions such as the Shiromani Gurudwara Prabhandak Committee and more recently the Delhi Sikh Gurudwara Management Committee. Although the Shiromani Akali Dal remained committed to the broader objectives of Indian independence from Britain, its primary mission remained the promotion and protection of the rights of the Sikh minority. The objective of cultivating religious and regional identity and also assumes power in Punjab for many, many years till present day. Jammu and Kashmir National Conference, JKNC, is a regional political party in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The Jammu and Kashmir National Conference was founded at Srinagar by Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah. It was re-christened at the JKNC on June 11, 1939. The JKNC has been a strong protagonist for trade between Jammu and Kashmir state and the portions of the Kashmir region administered by Pakistan. The top leadership of the JKNC has always remained within the Abdullah family since the party's founding. Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah was the president until 1981, at which time his son Farooq Abdullah succeeded him. In 2002, Farooq's son, Omar Abdullah, became president, although when Omar became chief minister of the state in January 2009, he left the office. The Jammu and Kashmir National Conference, JKNC, was founded in October 1932, after the All Jammu and Kashmir Muslim Conference. The party has maintained a stand that the disputed state of Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India, but it also opted for an autonomous state. As we all know, that the leadership of JKNC has always remained with the Abdullah family. During the time of Indian independence from Britain in 1947, Sheikh Abdullah assumed what was then the office of the Prime Minister of Kashmir. The state's first elections in its legislative assembly were held in September 1951, and JKNC won all 75 seats. As time progressed, in 1965, the JKNC merged with the Indian National Congress, also known as the Congress Party today, and became the Jammu and Kashmir branch of Congress. Hence, the main objective of the Jammu and Kashmir National Conference is to protect the interests of the Kashmiri people and protection of the autonomous status. The Assam Jan Parishad is also known as Assam People's Council or Assam Jana Parishad, AGP. It's a regional political party in the state of Assam in the northeastern part of India. The AGP's initial objective was to protect the interests of the residents living in the state of Assam. It also started by seeking to deport a large number of illegal immigrants who had been coming into the state mainly from Bangladesh, especially since the early 1970s. Over time, it developed a broader goal of protecting and promoting the regional identity of the state. Between 1979 and 1985, Assam experienced a prolonged popular uprising by those strongly opposed to the presence of illegal immigrants in the state. The movement was largely headed by the All Assam Students Union, AASU, led by Prafulla Kumar Mahanta. After an agreement with the central government, and that took time, in 1985, the AASU and others collaborated in the formation of the AGP, also known as the Assam Jan Parishad, in order to provide a political alternative to the ruling Indian National Congress. Success at the state level came early for the AGP. Even though the party had not yet been registered, its candidates participated in the Assam Legislative Assembly elections that were held in December 1985. They won a majority of seats in the 126-member assembly and formed a government. Prafulla Kumar Mahanta, who had been named party president, became the chief minister. The objectives of the AGP are to resolve the problems of displaced people, protect the unique cultural, linguistic, and social identity of Assam, economic development of Assam, and for now assumes power in Assam for many years. The Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam was founded by C.N. Annadurai. It was a justice party, a non-Brahmin movement in the 1920s that was transformed into Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam, a regional political party. In 1944, Justice Party came to be known as Dravida Kazhagam. In 1944, a group separated from this party and established another party known as the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam. Another group separated from this party in the year 1972 and established the All India Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam, the AIDMK. Protection of the Tamil identity, member of coalition government at the center for some years, are some of the objectives and features of this party. This party has support of voters from all sections of the society. It was in power for a long period of time and has implemented many policies. In India, we have many regional parties in every state that has influenced the state politics. There are many regional parties that exist in Maharashtra itself apart from the Shiv Sena. That is the Maharashtra Nav Nirman Sena, Peasants and Workers Parties, the Republican Party of India, Bahujan Mahasangh, Republican Party of India, and the Samajwadi Party. As you can see in this table, it tells us about the election years they have won each party wise. So Shiv Sena won 44 seats in the year 2009 and 63 seats in the year 2014. The Maharashtra Nav Nirman Sena won 13 seats in 2009 and 1 seat in 2014. The Peasants and Workers Party won 4 seats in 2009 and 3 seats in 2014. The Republican Party of India, that is the Bahujan Mahasangh, won 1 seat in 2009 and 1 seat in 2014. As well as the Samajwadi Party
won 4 seats in 2009 and 1 seat in 2014. The remaining regional parties in Maharashtra and their representation in the Vidhan Sabha is as follows. Bahujan Vikas Aghadi had 2 seats in 2009 and 3 seats in 2014. The Rashtriya Samaj Paksh had 1 seat in 2009 and 1 seat in 2014. The Jana Surajya Shakti had 2 seats in 2009 and no seats in 2014. The All India Majlis-e-Ittehadula Muslimin had no seats in the year 2009 but 2 seats in 2014. The Lok Sangram and the Swabhimani Party had 1 seat in the year 2009 and no seats in the year 2014. Well, students, let's have a quick recap to this question and answer session. What changes have taken place in the nature of the political parties in India? Well, yes, you are right. The separatist movements, as well as they also demanded for more autonomy, the representation at national level, were the different changing natures of the regional parties. Second question, can you give me a short answer about the Shiv Sena Party? Yes, the Shiv Sena Party was started by Bal Thackeray in the year 1966. The main objectives of the party was to protect the rights of Marathi people and to promote the Marathi language. We also learned that the party formed a coalition government along with the BJP. And then it also continued an alliance in the year 2019 and formed the government along with the Congress Party and the National Congress Party, NCP. Can you give me a short note on the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam? Yes, we just revised that. We also know the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam was a party that was divided on multiple occasions. It was Justice Party and came to be known as the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam in the year 1944. And thus it divided and was parted in the year 1972 and established a separate part known as the All India Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam. The objectives of this party are as follows. To protect the Tamil identity and to support its members of the community. The last question is, can you tell me about the Shiromani Akali Dal? Well, students, you are right. The Shiromani Akali Dal was a movement that started in the year 1920, giving rise to a national political party. Now we know the objective of this party is to maintain and promote the religious and regional identity of the Sikh community. And this party has its hold in the state of Punjab in India. Thank you, students. Hope you enjoyed and understood all the different political parties present in India today and their emergence before independence and after independence and the impact they have on our lives, our culture and our living. Thank you.